Evening, everybody. It's Friday night, and we are beginning our new season here at Prestige Sim Racing. Okay, so for tonight, this is something new that we have not done before. We are starting the Prestige Sim Racing Club Series Invitational. And we tried to think of another word or two to throw in there to make it even longer than that, but we got bored with it. So we gave up, and that's what it is. It's the Club Series. So here's how this works. On Friday nights, we're going to be racing at the same track, same conditions as we will be doing our GT3 league on Sundays. However, on Friday nights, which is typically our invitational night, which means it's open to everyone, we were starting to have a little bit of attendance problems on Friday night, mostly because, you know, it's summer, COVID's ending, people are out doing stuff. People just aren't sim racing quite as much as they used to. So what we've done is we started the Club Series. The Club Series is 10 individuals who are signed up for the entire season of 12 races, and we will be racing for points. Points, standings, trophies at the end, and all of that kind of thing. We are all going to be driving GT4s. The other 10 grid positions that are open for each of those races are essentially first come, first serve basis. Anyone can race in them whenever they want to. They can choose to race either GT3 or GT4. So chances are most people are going to take GT3, turning it into a legit multi-class race most every Friday, which we like to do a lot, and that's kind of where we're at tonight. We are currently sitting on, I think, 10 GT4 cars and 6 GT3s. We're at Laguna Seca, which is an amazing track and a really tough one to do multi-class racing at because it's so tight. Not a lot of room to make overtakes and clean passes. So everybody's got to be patient and be careful. But yeah, that's so, you know, we're back at it. This is round one of the Club Series, and we are about to start the GT3 qualifying here in just a second. I'm driving the KTM for this entire series. Why? Because I love slow cars that make it a challenge to beat other people on a track. I think if you jump into like a Merc or the Audi or something along those lines, I think you're making things too easy on yourself. Those cars are too fast, they're too OP, and you're really just a loser if you try to drive one of those. I think you've got to go for a challenge, which is why I took the KTM. And none of that is actually true. I just really like driving the KTM. I was initially thinking I was going to go with the McLaren GT4 because the McLaren is what I'm driving for the GT3 league. So I thought I'd do that. But I drove it a few times and it just never wowed me. And the reality is I've taken the KTM out a couple of times in the past and it just makes a lot of sense to me. I know it's not the fastest car, but I feel like I understand it and that it suits my driving style. And that means that I can really be very consistent in it. I can put the car exactly where I want it 99% of the time and not make a lot of huge mistakes. At least that's my impression of it. So while it may struggle certainly at some tracks, especially some of the bigger tracks because it lacks for some power, I think from the standpoint of consistency, it should do pretty well over the course of 12 races. And that's kind of what I'm trying to find out. Matrix is asking me, how wide am I going to make the KTM on the straights? And the answer is, I'm going to drive it sideways, so that no one in a faster car can get around me. As always, for our mixed class races, we set a 20-minute qualifying session, and the GT3s qualify during the first 10 minutes. GT4s go out for the second 10 minutes. Keeps track clear and make sure we're not bumping into each other. Oh, and by the way, livery, all black. I went matte black with just a little bit of gloss black because the KTM basically looks like the Batmobile or an F-117 stealth fighter. So I thought, why not roll with that all the way and just go all black? And, you know, I think it looks exactly like it's supposed to. Come on, Madly, get a lap in there so you're not stuck behind all of us. You got it. Attaboy. Ratman's going to be very tough on Sunday in that Porsche, I think. I've seen him doing some practice, and he's got plenty of speed as far as the GT3 race goes. Plan B pretty much owns this track, so in a lot of ways, he's in the GT4 tonight. But whether he's in a GT3 or a GT4, he's just really fast at Laguna Seca. So unless he just has a bad race and makes a big mistake somewhere, my feeling is most of us are kind of racing for second place. But who knows, you know? You go out there, you give it your best effort, see what happens. But he's quick. And he's consistent, too. He's quick and he's consistent on this track. And that's a tough combination to beat. Well, that's not bad. I'll take that. That's very close to my personal best. What did I did a 31.8, I think. I think a 31.7 or a 31.8 is my personal best on this track in a GT4, so that's pretty close to the best I can offer. See if Plan B or Matrix can squeak one in there under me. I won't be the least bit surprised if either of them do. Well, Matrix isn't. He's already in the pits. Where's Plan B? 46. 56. He's on the back, and he's not. He's pulling off. He must have invalidated that lap. Angry? You got something, maybe? Yeah, angry snuck it in. Look at that. Attaboy. Great lap, man. Great lap. Boy, look at that. That's basically a tenth of a second. Nice. Okay. Pit stop for tires, no fuel. Twenty-three, two, twenty-two, six, twenty-two, six, twenty-two, two. That looks good. 70 liters. Tire set 10 and 11. Brakes 2 and 2. That all looks good. In a way, unfortunately, I think all of the races we're doing for the club series are mandatory tires and not particularly long races. So it kind of negates one of the big advantages of the KTM, which is that it's excellent on tires. If we had a no pit stop 1 hour race, that would actually be pretty advantageous for me in the KTM. But I don't think we have anything like that for this opening season. Well, that wasn't a good start for us, Plan B. You go ahead. I'm going to assume that was my fault until I see otherwise, but I don't know. It might have been both of us. Seconds, almost 10 seconds worth of damage. Thank you. Well, if Plan B gets up close enough to me and gets an opening, I will let him go by for a couple of reasons. One, because I'm not sure whether that mishap was my fault or not, and I'm pretty bummed about it. And two, he and I don't need to be fighting because we're both quick enough to work our way up. And I think I'll give him an opening on the next corner. Not like that, man. Okay, Ratman, where are we going to do this at? Hopefully on the back straight. Come on, man, get it together. Okay, let's go for it.
Car on the left. Clear on the left. Yellow flag in sector one.
Missed it. Damn it. Well, in a short race like this, I decided not to repair the damage because I didn't think it was affecting me enough to be worth the nearly 10 seconds I'd be sitting in the pits. And I decided to pit immediately because the tires really don't matter a ton.
Mandatory stop is not clear. Come on, let's go.
For the KTM.
No tire pressure. Stay clear on the car.
and I was coming up on traffic, so I'd rather do it then and see if I can turn some quick laps and undercut some people.
Thank you.
Uh-oh.
Thank you.
The car coming up behind you.
Oh, plan B, did you have an off track? somebody dropped out, and I'm not sure who it is.
Clear on the left.
It's really hard to do donuts in this thing. Well, okay. A couple of thoughts. First of all, Plan B, if you watch this, I don't yet know. I'm going to watch the replay as soon as we were able to clear out of the server here. But regardless, my apologies, whoever was at fault. I honestly don't know yet. I'll take, at the very least, some of the blame without knowing anything more, because I kind of suspect we both might have been a little bit to blame there, but we'll find out here in a second. Regardless, that's obviously not how I wanted to start this thing off, so my apologies for that. Beyond that, I think that the... I think that the call I made as far as the pits go, I think was the correct one. I got a lot of track position off of that by doing the undercut and not repairing the damage. I don't think I would have caught Angry or Matrix regardless. If I had done an additional 10 seconds, I'd have been too far back from them, even if I'd been able to run better lap times than what I was able to as is. So I don't think I was going to be able to do any better than P3 regardless, so I'm thinking that was the right call there. Now, I think we should be good. Matrix should have the screenshot, so let's go take a quick look at the replay. Okay. Let's see where we wind up. Now, that was on me 100%. Damn it. Judge that badly, but I did. I wasn't even trying to be aggressive. Just way too late on the brakes. I think the traffic made me look at the wrong sign off to the left-hand side. That's my best guess, because I would normally brake by right here. And I know I was trying to just, and I didn't start braking until the number one sign. I might have gotten confused there and missed those signs because I wouldn't brake that late even under normal circumstances. Plan B, that's on completely. My apologies. Well, that should be a penalty on me. Well, I'm not going to lie. I'm very disappointed in myself for that. Very, very disappointed in myself. A fun race other than that, but that's just, you know, I don't know. I hate that. It's not what we're here for. It's not what Plan B was here for, and it's not what we want. But I guess all you can say is don't let it happen again, you know. Just don't be that stupid again. Anyway, so there's that. Back here on Sunday night for the GT3 League race, same track, Laguna Seca, and hopefully not be such an idiot then. That was, sorry guys, that rubs me wrong. So have a good night, and hopefully we'll see you soon, okay? Good night.